Good morning, this is Judge Torres from Metro Court, wishing you a good day.
Hola, buenos dias. Good morning, judges.
Shana Damare, hello, judges. This is Scott Patterson, the Statewide Behavioral Health Manager with AOC, and today I want to talk to you a little bit about isolation and hopefully provide some tips that you find useful to mitigate some of the impacts or potential impacts of isolation. As you may know, there are 168 hours in every week, and as a judge, it's likely that you feel like you're on the clock for all of those hours. Being a judge is incredibly isolating. You might have a reduced peer group that you can reach out to, and it's really likely that the things that happen on a daily basis in work are not things that you can share with your friends, families, or loved ones, which obviously can lead to feeling isolation. So one of the things that we know about isolation is it impacts our emotional health. When we're isolated, it can make us feel a little more depressed. It can increase the likelihood that we experience some anxiety symptoms, and it can also make us just feel not at ease. The other thing, in the last few years, there's been research that shows that isolation also has impacts on our physical health. In one study in particular that I found interesting, isolation has the same physical body impact equivalent as smoking 15 cigarettes in a day or a day of heavy drinking. So let that sit in. Not only is isolation emotionally impactful, but it's also potentially physically impactful. There's a few things that you might be able to try in order to reduce some of the potential impacts of isolation. So connection obviously is the most important one. And we can connect in a whole bunch of different ways. You might be able to connect via the phone, text, video chat, Google Meets, Zoom, any of those things. We also know that now that restrictions are lifting a little, and now that more people are vaccinated, that we have the opportunity to connect with others in person. In-person connection can be important because when we have physical contact, such as a hug or a handshake, it causes our brain to release oxytocin. And oxytocin is not only a feel-good neurochemical, but it's also a neurochemical that allows us to feel a little more connected to other people. When we're talking to somebody in person, face-to-face, eye-to-eye, it allows for mirror neurons. So neurons in my brain to light up the same neurons in your brain. It allows for limbic resonance. It allows us to connect. It allows us to hold the space for one another. So I encourage you to try a few things, at least, I'd say once a day, if that's not realistic, at least 3 or 4 times a week. Pick up the phone and call somebody. Invite them for a walk. Invite them to lunch, to a coffee, to dinner, or just for a chat. If you happen to be in the office, walk down the office hallway and talk to another person. And don't talk necessarily about work, but just connect. Ask somebody how they're doing and give the time to actually listen to how they're doing. And the good thing is that when we connect with others, it not only makes us feel better and reduces the isolation, but it reduces the isolation for them. And the beautiful thing is that a phone works both ways. If we get in the habit of calling somebody or emailing somebody and making that connection, it's highly likely that they will do the same thing and reciprocate. Thank you for everything that you're doing. And I hope that you are able to integrate some way to connect with other people, other human beings on a daily basis for at least the next month, minimum at least 3 to 4 times a week. If you have any questions or you want any further tips, please feel free to reach out to me. Thank you again for everything you do.